go to the Affinity Designer's tool panel and go to the vector brush tool. There's the vector brush, select it and apply. Now the brush that I've applied will be different from yours. So I'm just gonna select the move tool and now I'm just gonna go to brushes. You find that in the view menu, studio and brushes, and apply one of the brushes. Just gonna apply any of them. You can also change the color, modify the layer styles, etc. via the layers panel. It's just a basic layer, see it there, it's a curve. But you can also go to the move tool and you can manipulate the curve in all kinds of different ways. However, what you can also do, you can edit it in Affinity Photo. So go to File and Edit in Photo. You can also use the Save File format as well. Now you can do exactly the same. Go over here, select the Node tool, and this is now in Photo. And then you can manipulate it here as well. So it's a vector brush inside Affinity Photo. You can move that around, change the colors if you want. And maybe go for red, go for, let's go to layers. I can add effects, so just bring up the effects, Gaussian blur, etc. If you want to add those, you can add it. But you can also say continue to manipulate this design. You can also select points and delete bits. So just go there, get rid of some of those nodes if you don't want as many as that, and maybe reduce it down. Just makes it easy to manipulate the design. You can also go over here, select the move tool, and you can go to layer and you can duplicate. So you can duplicate the design, create multiple copies of the design. Also, what you can do, go over here to the assets, and you need that in the view menu, studio and assets. You can just save it. So just go over there, add from selection. So you've got currently got selected. So add from selection, and now that's just added. So now what I can do, at any point later on, I can simply bring my vector brush back again, and I can still continue to manipulate it. I can go to the node tool and change position, change colors, etc. It's all still live and still editable. So you can just change it and create all kinds of super colorful designs with this approach. What you can also do is you can use this vector brush, however, as a raster brush. You can't use it as a vector brush in terms of adding it to the brushes panel. There's no vector brush feature there. That is one area that's would be nice, but obviously does not support. If you go up here, there's options here, new intensity, round, square, image. There's no feature for vector brushes. This vector brush is only because of Affinity Designer. So what you can do, change that, but you can also go to, now I'm just gonna go to a layer and rasterize. So I'm gonna rasterize it. That sounds odd, I know, but what I'm gonna do then is, once I've done that, I'm gonna resize it a bit so it's not just cut off. I notice slightly cut off, which is not what I want. And I'm gonna use a selection. So I'm just going to select this design. So select and selection from layer. So selection from layer, so it's all selected there. Now I could fill it with other brush strokes. So I could go to brush strokes over here. It's just a raster layer. And I could just add brushes to that. So create a real sort of unusual color design there. Maybe apply effects, go to filters, blur, Gaussian blur, say, get a nice blur effect in there and so on. But then you can go over to brushes, right click there on the brushes panel, which is view menu, studio and brushes, and new brush from selection. So new brush from selection, and there it's added into the brushes panel. Now at this point, I'm just gonna remove that layer, and also I'm gonna remove the vector layer as well. It lets me, let's just remove that, delete and delete. I've still got the residue of the selection, which I don't want. So I'm just gonna go now to the brushes and just go there, the brush, and now I can apply it. Select that one. That's the one I wanted. I was using the other one, which is not much use. So you can see what happens. You end up with this very, very colorful design, maybe slightly too big. And of course, what you can do, you can always modify it in other ways as well. So you can apply it like that. Let's just undo that now. And double click. So you can double click it, and now you can edit it. So you can think, well, you know what? I don't want it that big. Maybe about there. Maybe spacing, change that. Maybe rotation, change dynamics, change the size, just to see if you're using a pen, you can use pressure, and let's say rotation as well. And maybe if you want it to be nice and colorful, you can just use that saturation and so on. And now I can display it again. And you can see the design there. And of course it's a layer, so it's a layer. What you can do, you can go to effects, and you can say, well, you know what? I want an outer shadow there. So you can add a shadow there, or maybe add 3D to the design. Sort of just go down to 3D, and so on. So you can create a variety of different designs using this vector brush. And of course, it's all still on the same layer. So you can see now you get a nice 3D a brush effect all the way from the vector design that was before in Affinity Designer. As I said, you need Affinity Designer, you need Affinity Photo, both to work this approach. Hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.